What's up, y'all? Welcome to the Harris House.
It's a good day to be in the Harris House.
This is another episode of Motivational Monday.
All right, so our discussion topic for today is going to college, staying in college.
That's a big topic.
It really is. So, disclaimer and our first point, college ain't for everybody.
College is not for everyone. I want to motivate everyone out there. And this is actually a great motivational point that college isn't for everyone. And I'm saying that personally, being a person that, individual that love college, that love to go to school, college isn't for everyone. In my freshman year in college, a lot of individuals I came with in a band, we call it Crowd Brothers, a lot of my crowd brothers that I've actually came with, they dropped out. More than 80% of them dropped out. It's for all different reasons. It's for financial reasons, grades, or just not doing what you're supposed to do.
Right. Before we get into the freshman year part, we want to expand a little bit on the college is not for everyone portion, because we don't want you to think that you should go to college and stay in college when it's not meant for you to go to college.
Not saying that you need college to be successful.
Yeah,
that's another point. True. That's another point we're going to discuss. But not saying that you need college to be successful. That's what I'm saying. College is not for everyone. There are some people actually pursue to be rappers or pursue to be NFL players or NBA players.
Right. But you have to have a plan. You have to have a goal in mind. So we're going to move on to the next point, which is freshman year.
Everybody's scared of this year. You're actually excited.
Yeah.
You're excited, man. You're excited to go to college. Your parents drop you off. This is the first time you get to ever be away from your parents. Even if you live in state or out of state, you get to be away from your parents and have your own rules. And that's where the mistakes come in place.
My freshman year, that was my first time being away. I was more excited about meeting friends and meeting people and being around a completely different environment. There were a lot of challenges.
I'm telling you, like, your freshman year is nice, man. I'm not saying not go to college your freshman year and have fun. You're going to go to parties. I'm not saying don't go to parties. I'm motivating you. If you're going to go to parties,
be around people you trust.
Be around people you trust and also do what you got to do. Don't just be going to parties. Oh, man, I know I got this essay due tomorrow. I get it done. I procrastinated. All right. You keep saying that. 50% of them people come in freshman year of college do not come back after Christmas break.
The goal here is that if you go to college, understand when you decide to go to college that you should stay there. So although you experience life, you experience parties, and it's okay to do all those things, grades are really important.
Grades are definitely
important,
guys. Let me tell you something about the GPA. It's easy to go down. It's hard to come up. It typically takes about a good 3 years to put your GPA up a point. A point.
Yeah.
Just making an A and a B in one semester, you're already at a 3.0.
I'm going to be transparent because I feel like transparency is important. So my freshman year, I'm going to use my freshman year as an example. It's very different from his because he always keep a 4.0. But for me, I started up early in the summer. I went through a summer bridge program. Best time of my life. Like, I will never forget that. The summer bridge program, we had two classes. I had an A and a B. Started off with a 4.0. Ended off with a 3.5 because I made a B. Very upsetting. Freshman year, a lot was going on. Started band. That was really hard to juggle with school while also going to parties and hanging out and having fun and doing all this stuff. My GPA dropped from a 3.5 in one semester to a 2.78.
I'm telling you, it is serious.
It is so serious.
And in my situation, coming to college, yeah, we went to a bridge program. I was in band. We did this bridge program. I know y'all, I said 3.0. Actually, A and B is a 3.5.
Mm-hmm.
Because I made it was my only C in college. Really, one of my only, I only made two C's in college. But They were my first two classes of college in that bridge program. I made an A in one and a C in the other one, and I ended off that summer with a 3.0, which harmed me for the rest. Even though I ended with a 3.7 graduating, but undergrad, it's hard. Just think if I would have made an F, it would have been 2.5 or 2.0.
Right, exactly. Mine went, I only could get it up to a 3.0. I graduated with 3.0.
It's hard. It's called recovery. GPA recovery from freshman year.
GPA after college, it's not necessarily too important, but what's really important is your GPA while you're in college. It opens up so many opportunities for you. There's so many things that require a good GPA. There's so many things that I couldn't participate in because my GPA was low. So just think about that your freshman year.
I know every video you watch is going to say stay focused. I'm trying to motivate you. Just please stay focused.
That brings us to our next point. You have to understand why you're there to begin with. I had that realization. Is that a word? Realization, whatever. But I realized that my freshman year, after my GPA dropped from a 3.5 to a 2.78, I literally talked to myself and told myself, bro, you're not here for all these activities. You're not here to talk to people and become friends and do all that. Yeah, that comes with it, but that's not priority. Priority is graduating with a good GPA while still having a good experience.
Because watch this, they major in, probably finish in 4 years and you're in 5. So they gone. They ain't gonna do what they gotta do. They gone, but you still there. You was too busy worrying about them. Now you there 7 years. You gotta do what you gotta do. Know what you there for.
Understand.
Is it worth it?
Yeah.
Is college worth it?
It's so worth it.
Like, I can too. I know at the beginning we stated that you can still be. Don't get me wrong. Motivation people that do not want to go to college. I said what you have to do is put in that work. You don't go to college, so you already put yourself under. You already put yourself under many, many, many people. If you do not go to college, you got to network. But is it worth it? I say it's completely.
It's so worth it.
Completely worth it.
It's so worth it, and it's not just college and being able to graduate and get a job. It's also the experience that you have.
It's worth it, guys. It's worth it. I love to learn, and as you see, y'all got plenty of people that's actually going back to school. You got Megan Thee Stallion. She went to PV, transferred to TSU, graduated from TSU. You got plenty of other people that some of you guys look up to is going back to college. Wish they would have went to college when they had a chance. But, you know, their career took off being an artist. And so all I'm saying is there's some great pros into going to college. It's some awesome pros to going to college. You can, not only that, I'm going to finish it off right here. You can meet the love of your life. You can meet your wife or your husband in college. That's all. I'm going to just close it out right there. Always remember, stay safe.
Stay motivated.
And always be yourself. See you next Monday. We out.